Hello friends, I hope you all are doing good. In this video, we are going to discuss the amplitude modulation in analog communication. So, I have already discussed about the amplitude modulation in one of my previous video. I hope you all have gone through that video. So now in this video, I am again starting the amplitude modulation with the basics. So I am going to discuss what is amplitude modulation, its waveform, its mathematical parameters, and after that we are going to discuss the single tone amplitude modulation with its mathematical parameters in this video. So when I talk about amplitude modulation is the instantaneous change in the amplitude of the carrier signal with respect to the instantaneous value of the amplitude of the message signal. So now my message signal is the baseband signal, I already told you. So the instantaneous change in the amplitude of the carrier signal with respect to the baseband signal is amplitude modulation. So now I hope you remember that I told you the carrier signal does not carry any information. Why? Because its parameters are constant. Throughout the length or throughout the time, the amplitude of the carrier signal would be constant, and same goes for the frequency and phase of the carrier signal. So the frequency and phase and amplitude, all of these parameters are constant in the carrier signal throughout its length. So this is the property of the carrier signal. So now how can I transmit my message with a constant amplitude, frequency and phase carrier signal? So I can superimpose my message signal on the carrier signal. So now here in the amplitude modulation, I am superimposing the message signal with respect to the amplitude of the carrier signal. So now here I am changing the amplitude of the carrier signal with respect to my baseband message signal. So amplitude modulation is So now as I mentioned here, amplitude modulation is the change in the amplitude of the carrier signal with respect to the instantaneous value of the amplitude of the baseband message signal. So now I am changing the amplitude of the carrier with respect to the message signal in short. So now let's suppose I have the message signal which is represented by XT. So XT represents the baseband message signal. So now my carrier signal is a sinusoidal wave. So I am representing CT as my carrier signal. So I can represent the carrier signal as VC cos omega CT. So this is my carrier signal, which is a sinusoidal carrier signal having the amplitude VC and the frequency represented by omega C. So omega C is 2 pi fc. So this frequency and amplitude VC are constant throughout the length, and I am taking the phase to be 0. So now let MT to be my modulated signal. So now let's understand this thing with the help of an example. So let the XT to be represented with this signal. So let's suppose this is my message signal. It's also a sinusoidal signal. So now let's suppose this is my carrier signal. So now this is my carrier signal. I hope you can see I have made the amplitude to be constant and also the frequency to be constant. So VC is the amplitude and the frequency is FC. So the frequency is very high when I compare to the message signal. So now the amplitude modulated signal. So now this is my modulated signal MT. So this was my CT and this was my XT. So now what happened? If I have to represent it mathematically, so MT was, I just added the amplitude. So here the amplitude is VM plus VC. So whatever my XT is my modulating signal, message signal. So now it is added to the amplitude of the carrier signal and now the frequency remains same. So now omega is same. So I am just adding the message signal to the amplitude. So here I am adding the message signal to the amplitude. So now if I represent MT, so MT can be represented as the summation of XT cos omega CT plus VC cos omega CT. So now if I have to represent the frequency spectrum of this modulated message signal, so I should know the frequency spectrum of XT cos omega CT and VC cos omega CT. So now I know the frequency spectrum of cos omega CT. So whenever I have to represent any signal in frequency domain, what I'll do? I'll see its Fourier transform. I know the Fourier transform of cos omega CT. So cos omega CT's Fourier transform is pi del omega minus omega C plus del omega plus omega C. So this is the Fourier transform of cos omega CT. So now VC is a constant. When I'll multiply a constant here, the constant would be multiplied here as well. So this is the property of the Fourier transform. I hope you remember this property. So now coming to the second term. The second term is XT cos omega CT. So now I can represent XT cos omega CT as, so the representation of cos omega CT would be e raised to power omega CT j omega CT plus e raised to power minus j omega CT upon 2. So I can represent XT cos omega CT as, I'm just expanding cos omega CT. So it would be XT into e raised to power j omega CT plus e raised to power minus j omega CT upon 2. So now I know the frequency shift property. So whenever XT is multiplied by e raised to power j omega CT, the Fourier transform would be represented by the shifted value. So it represents the shifted value in the frequency domain. So 1 by 2 is a constant. So taking 1 by 2 outside, XT into e raised to power j omega CT would be represented as X omega minus omega C. So here I am shifting the frequency by omega C plus X omega plus omega C. So this is my Fourier transform of the second term. So if I represent this by equation 1 and this by equation 2, so the frequency spectrum of the modulating message signal would be represented as, so M m omega. So omega represents the frequency domain of the modulated message signal mt. So m of omega would be summation of equation 1 plus equation 2. So m of omega would be vc pi del omega minus omega c plus del omega plus omega c plus half x omega minus omega c plus x omega plus omega c. So this is my m of omega. So this represents the frequency spectrum of the modulated message signal. So now coming to the single tone modulation. So single tone modulation is a modulation using the single frequency amplitude of the message signal. So now I am taking the single frequency component of the message signal. So now xt could be represented as, here I am taking only one frequency of the message signal. So it is also an example of single tone amplitude modulation. Here I took only one frequency. So xt would be taking the amplitude to be Vm cos omega mt. So here I just took one frequency, which is omega m is 2 pi fm. So now my frequency is fm. So this is my single tone modulation. So now how I can represent the amplitude modulated signal? So mt is vm cos omega mt. So this is my message. It is added to the amplitude of the carrier, which is vc, and it is supplied with the help of same frequency fc. So this is my modulated signal. So now how I can represent it? So now what I did, I took the vc common. So outside I am left out with vc cos omega ct. So I just take out vc common. So here I am left out with Vm by Vc cos omega mt plus this Vc I took outside. So here I am left out with 1 only. So now I am representing Vm by Vc by m. So m is my modulation index. So I am representing Vm by Vc by m. So now I can represent mt as Vc cos omega ct 1 plus m omega mt cos omega mt. Sorry. So now this is my modulated signal. So now modulated signal in general form can be represented as vc cos omega ct 1 plus m into x of t. So now x of t is my message signal and m is my modulation index. So now this is my generalized term. So now taking this term, this is my equation 3. So now coming back to the equation 3, I can expand this equation and I can write mt as vc cos omega ct plus, now vc cos omega ct is multiplied by this term. So here I am left out with mvc cos omega ct plus into cos omega mt. So now this is my carrier signal. So here I have cos omega ct into cos omega mt. I know the formula of 2 cos a cos b. So now what I can do here, I can multiply with 2 and also divide by 2. So mt would be represented as, so vc cos omega ct plus mvc upon 2 into 2 cos omega ct cos omega mt. So this formula now becomes 2 cos a cos b. So now I can represent this as cos a plus b plus cos a minus b. So mt would be vc cos omega ct. I am just replacing this term as it is. So now it would be mvc by 2 into cos omega c plus omega mt plus cos omega c minus omega m t. So now this represents my empty. So now if I have to represent the empty, so if this is my frequency and this is my amplitude, so this is my frequency omega c. So this I am taking to be omega c. This is omega c plus omega m, omega c plus omega m, and this is omega c minus omega m. So now here at omega c minus omega m, so the amplitude is mvc by 2. So mvc by 2, so here the amplitude is mvc by 2. Here at omega c plus omega m as well, the amplitude is mvc by 2, and at the frequency omega c I have the amplitude vc. So now this is my vc. So now here you can see I have this vc cos omega c t. So this represents the carrier signal. So mt is my carrier signal plus mvc by 2 cos omega c plus omega m t plus cos omega c minus omega m t. So now this carrier signal, I already told you, it does not contain any information because its amplitude and frequency remains constant throughout the length. So this carrier signal is present in the output signal, which is a redundant term. So carrier signal is also taking power to transmit from the transmitter to the receiver. So this power which we are sending is redundant. So I hope you can see only this term contains the actual information sent by us. So only this term is required for sending our signal from the transmitter to the receiver. So now this term is the only term which we require. So we can improve upon this amplitude modulation, and how I am going to discuss in my upcoming videos. So stay tuned for those videos. Now I am winding up my session here. I hope you understood each and everything which I discussed here. If not, you can put your doubt in the comment box and I'll try to resolve it as soon as possible. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel and push the like button. Thank you.